Shalom Aleichem and welcome to Online Smicha. There's a din in Hilchos in Chesha Mishpat where it talks about Geneva, Gzela. Obviously, we all know you're not allowed to steal. But sometimes we don't pay attention and things that don't seem to be called stealing. Halachically, there is an issue with the Geneva. And that is a Shoyol Shalomi Das. Shoyol Shalomi Das is using somebody's thing, something that belongs to somebody else, not being sure that the person allows you to use it, but you're going to give it back. You just need a temporary usage. Now, halacha is a shoyel shalai midas. A lot of times, most of the time, is considered pure gneva, pure gzela, because who knows if the person allows you to use it. There is an exception to this rule, and it's also brought in Hilchos Tzitzis, that there's a rule that we follow that nichalei la'adam, a person is happy if with their belongings a person does a mitzvah. So we could assume that if it's an item that's made for a mitzvah, people are happy other people perform the mitzvah with their stuff. So then because of that assumption, it's not considered geneva. You don't necessarily have to have a verbal permission from the person. So in Hilchos Tzitzis, in Siman Yud Dalet, over there, there's discussion, could I walk into a shul and realizing I don't have my talis gadol, could I just take anybody's talis from the shul and use it? So the reason why possibly yes is because of this svara, nichalei la'adam, every person we believe is happy that others use their things for mitzvahs, but as long as you put it back neatly, don't leave it in a mess. If it's folded, put it back the way it's folded, that's fine. The question becomes, how about an item that's not necessarily the biggest mitzvah, but it's customary to use? And the question which is relevant for Rosh Hashanah Yom Kippur is a kittel. Yes, it says in Shulchan Aruch that people wear white garments for many reasons on the night of Yom Kippur and the day of Yom Kippur to look like malachim, to remember Yom HaMisa, different reasons why you wear a kittel. So what happens if a person comes to shul and chapzich, ui, I forgot my kittel. But he sees that somebody else has a kittel here. I don't know if he's showing up or not. May I use that kittel, assuming that person will allow it? Now, the difference is that tzitzis is a pure mitzvah, a mitzvah semen a Torah, most of the times. Kittel is not a mitzvah. Could we just accept that same rule applies here? So we have to discuss this from many angles. First of all, in the Aruch HaShulchan, you have to know that in Hilchos Tzitzis, he says not necessarily this halacha stays today, that you can just take somebody's tzitzis. People are so particular. People are so careful, and they don't like other people's shvitz, and people like to use their own and not necessarily allow everybody to just use this. If that's a way by a tzitzis, of course, by a kittel, which you sit in it most of the day, it's mechasa kol aguf, there is shvitz. There is another reason why not necessarily you're allowed to use somebody's kittel without permission. Now, there is a plus about a kittel over a tzitzis, and that is a kittel, even if you use after Yom Kippur, you'll put it to the cleaners, voila, it's back to clean, and it won't bother anybody. Tzitzis, a lot of people have issues with putting the talus into their tzitzis. It changes the color, it makes it more yellow. So this is debatable, and obviously it's best to use your own kittel. If you come to a situation where you don't have your kittel and you see somebody's kittel hanging, if you get permission, obviously then it's allowed. Even if you don't get permission, if you use it, you have to put it to the cleaners and put it back where it was. So in case it was put in a designated area, the person will find it right away.